In the last video, I gave a brief introduction to Gibbs free energy and the delta G of a reaction. In this video, we will look at the implications of delta G for the progress of chemical reactions. Left to itself, a chemical reaction will proceed in the direction in which Gibbs free energy is released. For example, in the diagram, the products have a lower Gibbs free energy than the reactants, and delta G for the reaction is negative. There will be net conversion of reactant molecules to product molecules. Note that the backward reaction will sometimes occur, in which the products are converted to reactants. However, more often, reactants are converted to products, such that the net direction of the reaction is forward, from left to right as shown. Reactions for which delta G is negative are said to be energetically favorable or spontaneous. As the reaction proceeds and reactants are converted to products, the concentration of reactants will fall, and the concentration of products will rise. Because Gibbs free energy depends on concentration, as the reaction proceeds, the Gibbs free energy of the reactants will fall, and that of the products will rise. At some point, the Gibbs free energies on both sides of the equation will be equal, and delta G will equal zero. At this point, the reaction is said to be at equilibrium. The forward and backward reactions continue to happen, but there is no net conversion of reactants to products, or of products to reactants. One can also imagine a situation in which the Gibbs free energy of the products is greater than that of the reactants, such that the delta G is positive. In this case, the net reaction will proceed backwards, as written, from the so-called products to the reactants. The forward reaction, as written, is energetically unfavorable and will not proceed spontaneously. So, to sum up, for any chemical reaction, if the delta G is negative, the forward reaction is favored. If the delta G is positive, the reverse reaction is favored. In either case, if undisturbed, the reaction will proceed in the favored direction until delta G equals zero and a dynamic equilibrium is reached. Let's further consider a reaction that has reached equilibrium. Recall that the forward and backward reactions are proceeding at the same rate. Take a moment to think about what would happen in this system if the concentration of the reactants increased. You might want to pause the video. If the relative concentration of the reactants increases, the Gibbs free energy of that side of the reaction increases. The forward reaction therefore becomes more favorable than the reverse reaction. There will be a net flow of molecules from left to right. In other words, the net flow of molecules in the reaction shifts to counteract the original change in concentration of reactants. As that happens, the concentration of reactants falls and the concentration of products rises, until eventually the Gibbs free energies are equal again and the reaction has been brought back to equilibrium. Likewise, if the concentration of the reactants now falls, the backward reaction would be favored until equilibrium is restored. This effect is known as Le Châtelier's principle. As a result of Le Châtelier's principle, relatively small changes in reactant or product concentration can change the net flow of substrates forward or backward through the reactions that are at or near equilibrium. Such reactions are said to be reversible, because the net flow of molecules in the reaction can shift direction in response to relatively small changes in metabolite concentration. Now suppose that the conversion of reactants to products has a large negative delta G. The forward reaction is heavily favored, and the reverse reaction happens at a much, much slower rate. The rate of the reverse reaction is so small relative to the rate of the forward reaction that reactions with very negative values for delta G are often said to be irreversible. For these reactions, small changes in metabolite concentration have only a minor impact on the delta G and cannot make the reverse reaction occur to any substantial degree. Irreversible reactions are therefore insensitive to changes in metabolite concentration. We've seen how the delta G dictates which direction of a chemical reaction is favored. Sometimes, a cell may want to carry out an energetically unfavorable reaction and convert reactants into products, even though the delta G for the reaction is positive. I'll describe how the cell solves this problem in the next video.